run live polls in your PowerPoint presentation to help make your lesson more engaging and to solicit some live student responses. So you guys can do this all right in PowerPoint without having to switch between different apps or browsers when you use ClassPoint. So I'm going to show you guys how you can use ClassPoint to set up some live polls while you're preparing for class to poll your students during class, and how to do it if you didn't set it up and just on the fly get some responses from your students. Hi everyone, I'm Sarah from InkNote and welcome to the ClassPoint channel. If you haven't already, show us some love by hitting that subscribe button. You guys can stay updated with all of our latest videos on helping you in the classroom. Today's video is all about live polling in PowerPoint. So we all know it can be a bit challenging to keep our students interested in the material that we're teaching. However, when we run live polls, it can help our students stay involved in the lesson and gather some live instant feedback for the teachers. Live polling can be used and is beneficial for a lot of different ways. So first, it really opens up the floor for a discussion. You can hear all of your students' opinions and lets them know that all of their voices are heard and their opinions do matter. Plus, it can really help you gather that student feedback. So this can help move on the discussion and can help you track all of your students' level of understanding. So I'm going to show you guys how you can do all of those things, live polling in PowerPoint with ClassPoint. So you guys have heard me say ClassPoint a couple of times now, and you might be wondering, what exactly is ClassPoint? ClassPoint is an interactive teaching add-in that just plugs right into your PowerPoint presentation that allows you to better interact and engage with your students using a multiple different question types. So if you guys don't have ClassPoint yet, you can download and install it at classpoint.io. For more details on that installation process, you can check out the information that is linked in the description below. So for now, I'm going to help you guys get started with making your slides interactive and what happens if you want to ask your students a question on a non-interactive slide. So we'll go through both of those, but to start, I have a slide deck pulled up here, and I do know that this first slide is a question that I want to live poll my students with. I want to gather their feedback and kind of see how they're doing on this. So to do that, I can just go to the InkNote ClassPoint tab up in that PowerPoint ribbon and click on the multiple choice button. So you guys will see a button appears on your slide. You can move it around, resize it as needed, and the side question panel appears. So this side question panel just has some different choices and customizable options on how you want your button to be ran during class. So the first thing we'll do is we'll change the number of choices just to 3. And for this example, I'm just going to do a regular poll. So there's no right answer. I just want to gather my students' feedback and check their level of understanding, and in this case, their opinion on if they liked the book so far or not. But if you guys want to, another way to poll your students is to have that correct answer and more of a quiz type question of making sure and letting them know if they got it right or wrong. So you can do that by selecting a correct answer here, or if there's more than one answer, you can do both here as well. Another fun thing with ClassPoint is we do have a competition mode that kind of turns your questions into a quiz game. So if you're interested in doing a quiz game in your PowerPoint, we have a link up above and down in the description below. But for now, we're just going to leave it how it is, and let's go into our presentation mode. And I'm going to use window mode here so that I can show you guys how students can join your class. So students just need to go to any browser and go to classpoint.app. And once they have classpoint.app pulled up, they just need to key in that class code that is in the right-hand corner of your screen, plus their name. And once that's done, you can click join and they'll be able to follow along with your slides. And once the teacher, you guys start your question type, the students will see their options on their side. So there's only one option that they can choose here. Let's say I'm really enjoying the book so far. I'll click A and submit, and on the teacher side, you'll see the responses appear live on screen. Once all of them are submitted, you guys can just go ahead and close that. You guys can then have an open discussion with your students about the results. You can discuss if they liked the book, if they didn't like the book, depending on what your question is. In addition, you guys can click into any of the bars to see who has submitted which answer. And to save them for later, if you want to review them, just click Save for Review, and you'll notice the question button is green, indicating that there's responses saved inside. So now what happens if I'm going through my information with my students and I have a question here, and as we're discussing, I really want to poll my students and see, you know, who thinks that this is right and who thinks that it's not right, and kind of get some feedback about that. And I don't have an interactive one here, but don't worry, on the ClassPoint toolbar, we do have a quick poll option. So here you'll see some automatic templates set, so you can have some feedback, yes, no, unsure, or true, false, along with just selecting kind of another multiple choice with these correct options. So I'm just gonna do a true, false here. And on your student side, they have their choices here, and they can submit that, and it'll appear on your teacher's side again. So the quick polls are a little bit different. If you have it closed and you want to save it, you're gonna have to insert them as a slide. Otherwise, if it was just really quick and there's no need to save, you guys can just exit and those results will be gone. So live polling is very interesting. It's a fun way to get some information from your students, but there are also some other ClassPoint question types that you can use too. So this example is just a short answer. You could also use word cloud. This way students can submit, you know, one or just a couple of words, and you can show your students the examples from each other and use that as a good way to start a discussion as well. So that is how you guys can use ClassPoint to live poll your students during class. There's so many different ways to use that live polling during class, like gathering your students' feedback, checking their level of understanding. You can use it to learn more about your students, and you can use it just for fun to get your students excited about class that day. Don't forget, if you guys haven't already, don't hit subscribe to stay updated on all of our latest EdTech tips and tricks and our ClassPoint tutorials. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you haven't already, don't forget also to download and install ClassPoint. Enjoy using it.